1, 2, 1, 2. We have about 4 minutes left of this last warm-up session. Session one is scheduled to start at 9:50. Swimmers, officials, and coaches, and everyone. Turn, just going to pay the announcement, hopefully it will work.
Depth of water though. Now the competition pool is 1.8 meters. All starting blocks at this venue are 700 millimeters above the surface of the water. Coaches and team managers are reminded that only those competitors who are competent shall be permitted to start with a shallow racing dive from the starting blocks. If there is a false start, you must continue with a shallow racing dive. You must not topple into the water head downwards as this is dangerous. If you are starting in the water, you must lower yourself over the side, do not jump or dive. Coaches and team managers, you are responsible for your swimmers at all times. Coaches and team managers, please ensure that all fire escapes are kept clear from clothing and belongings at all times. We would like to also remind you that hot drinks are prohibited on poolside at all times. Spectators, please note that using chairs other than those that are provided is prohibited along the walkway at the rear of the balcony. This area is an emergency escape route and must be kept clear at all times. The meet promoter in association with the management of K2 Leisure Centre will not accept responsibility for the loss or damage to any personal belongings left unattended on these premises. If you have any queries or concerns related to this announcement, then please contact a member of the event staff for more information. We thank you for taking your time to listen to this important safety announcement and hope you enjoy the competition.
Test to start. Test start.
Welcome everyone to the Swim Southeast Region Masters Meet at the K2. Now I've got a lot of referees here today. I think it's headed by John Tripp. And we've also got Dennis Vick, Peter Roycroft, Jean Scott, Becky Starks and Anne Cork. Lots of referees to make sure you're doing everything legally. Thank you ever so much for the people in white, our lovely officials that give up their time. Obviously the people in red, giving up their time to make sure this all runs very smoothly. Good luck to swimmers and competitors. You'll have the lovely Susie on the microphone, that's me, that's why I'm lovely. And also Ewan will be doing all the official chatter that I can't do. We have a lovely lads on the computers making sure there's a live link so you can re-watch your swim on YouTube. There we go. Don't say we're not into technology. Swimmers, you are reminded not to be poolside unless it is your race. I have been told many a time that this is a clear poolside policy and that you need to be on the seats in the gallery. And please don't bring any bags poolside. Also, if you have an accident, your swimming suit rips or you just fancy a new one, male sports will be open in the foyer throughout the meet. And don't forget the gentleman that has left his trunks, they're still here. That doesn't really want me to have any thoughts or visuals if you're not wearing your shorts. Right. Looks like we're ready for event one. Thank you. Event 1 is the mixed 400 IM, heat 1 of 2, referee.
Take your marks.
And away we go, heat number 1 of 2, and the first of a full day, a full schedule of events here at K2 in West Sussex. Kicking things off, Southern competitors from lane 1, Julian Meldrum of Bexley, into Planade Walker of Whitney, Will Reed of Teddington in 3, Lindsay Kellione, Didcot and Barramundi in 4, John Darby, City of Oxford in 5, Amanda Heath of Spencer in 6, and Dave Pethers, Kingston Royals, is in lane number 7. So our short course masters is underway, and as the day progresses, we'll let you know who's potentially going to be winning what as best we can. Of course, no presentations today, but medals available. So please make sure you collect those throughout the day as and when you know you're a winner. And everything, as we know, being live streamed on YouTube for you, so you can go home, watch it again later, or let any family, friends, loved one knows what is going on. Now, we are anticipating a pretty split pool in this one. Big, wide range of ages and abilities. But, out in front, Dave Pethers in Southern for Kingston Royals. Just to who heats in the mixed 400 IM. Next up, we'll have the 200 metre freestyle. Again, that's a mixed event. And then we begin later in the morning session to go into our designated male and female competitions. Pethers on his second out of the back of his backstroke. Amanda Heath not too far behind in lane 6, representing Spencer. And in 4, Lindsay Kellione, the swimmer from Didcot and Barramundi. Beautiful day outside. Of course, we do have 2 sessions in this competition. Session 2, if we look ahead right through the day, that'll be getting underway later on from 1:45, session number 2. With things in the individual competition being wrapped up by 5 p.m. And then, of course, as most of you will know, we have our relays later into the very late afternoon and early evening. And Pethers continues to lead on the breaststroke, followed by Amanda Heath and Lizzie Kellione. Going to be a job to catch Pethers now. Of course, Dave and Amanda in separate competitions. around the venue, we do have on the walls, especially at the back of the gallery, QR codes for you, so you can keep up to date with what's going on in terms of results and schedules, etc. So keep yourself in the know. Now, I'll tell you what, Amanda Heath has had a brilliant breaststroke here. Really pulled a good 15 metres back on Dave Pethers into the final 100 metres of the freestyle. Lindsay Kellione maintaining her third place position. It looks like it's going to be potentially her finishing place, even though with 100 metres to go. Although John Darby might have something to say about that on the freestyle. Let's wait and see. And Dave Pethers will go out and back one more time. And Amanda Heath is keeping him very honest. A 5.42 behind the 5.35 or thereabouts. Every single competitor on their freestyle leg. Everybody making their way home. And Dave Pethers for Kingston Royals will be victorious in our first heat of the day. His official time, 6.16.89. And Amanda Heath will come home in second place, 6.25.35 for her. Lindsay Kellione, she has been in a pretty solitary third position throughout this race. And she will touch home 6.48.71. One thing we don't have on our start sheets is entry time, so unfortunately can't let you know where people are competing against their previous bests and those entry times. But I'm going to guess that Dave Pethers is fairly satisfied with a 6.16.89. John Darby comes home in 7.12. Just a half a dozen seconds ahead of Will Reed and that Blanade Walker. And Julian Meldrum from Bexley Masters will close out heat number one for us.
Heat two, referee.
Take your marks.
Heat number two, and we have a full complement of eight, which is always lovely to see. From lane one, Fleur Turner of Basingstoke, Kellen Caldwell, Wickham District, Goncalo Amaral Pinto, home pool representing Crawley, Woking teammates in four and five, Henry Goodlad and Julie Howe. In six, Laura Kearns of Teddington. In seven, Wickham District's at Gregory de Terter. And in eight, Crawley's Alan Parkins. Now, with just two heats in the competition, and of course, the male and the female competition, various ages, very, very good chances of getting medals in age categories in this one for those willing to take on the 400 IM. We are just trying to see if we can get some entry times for you, because it does provide some lovely content when we're talking about how people are competing and doing against their own times. Pretty wide age gap in this one, over 30 years separating the youngest and the oldest. However, not often representative of swimming speed or class. In lane number four, Henry Goodlad, one of our Woking competitors, looking very strong indeed. .301 through 250 metres. The youngest in the pool at 26 years of age, the man in front. Now, next time they come and turn, let's have a look what's happening behind, because it's pretty tight. You've got Giancarlo Amaral Pinto up there, Julie Howe. And I thought it was close. 100th of a second separating Amaral Pinto and Julie Howe. Kellen Caldwell just 3 seconds back. And Gregory de Tertre, Fleur Turner. 100th of a second separating second and third. Looking incredibly unlikely that anyone will challenge Henry Goodard, led from the off. Fastest time from heat one, the 6:19 from Dave Peathers. That is not going to be a concern in the overall time, but he and Henry in different competitions. 4:55.32 goes sub 5 minutes for the 400 IM. Wonderful time for Goodlad. And the race for second and third place. It was separated by 100th of a second, 100 metres ago. And this time, they've just nipped up on the board now. Amaral Pinto, 5:10.42. And a 5:14 for Julie Howe, first woman home. Kelly Caldwell holding off Fleur Turner by 3.5 seconds. Gregory de Tertre into sixth place. Laura Kearns a 5:42. And Alan Parkins will go out and back one more time. This is the second of just two heats. This does close out our first event of the day. And there are lots of events today in our short course swimming Southeast Region Masters. And a big thanks to our hosts K2 and the wonderful West Sussex weather. Alan Parkins then, for his home club Crawley, a 6.24.64 for him.
Swimmers, will you clear the pool by the side, please? Swimmers, will you clear the pool by the side? Thank you.
Event 2 is the mixed 200 meter freestyle. Heat 1 of 9, referee.
Take your marks.
Nine heats in our second event. Going up first, Jenny Ball for Ride, Pauline Hogg having to Waterlooville, Catherine Martin for Bracknell, Alison Cowie, Buzzardon Phoenix, and Peter Stevens representing Spencer. 60 years between the youngest and the oldest in the pool in this one. Jenny Ball, I'm sure she won't mind me saying, at 85. For Ride, she's a 4.20 swimmer in the 200 free. And Catherine Martin, just 25, a 3.25 entry time. So there will be a bit of a difference here between first and last home. Peter Stevens, a 3.18 swimmer, our first male in this event. And this will be our second of two mixed events in the morning session. Beyond the nine heats here, we then go into the male and female split competitions. Once again, medals available throughout the morning. Once the results have been confirmed, ratified, etc., etc., they'll be available when they are ready to be collected. At the back of the gallery, at the diving board end, there will be a medals table. I'll give you a shout when they're actually ready to be collected. Not quite yet, of course. So nearing the conclusion of our first heat in our second event. Ball, Hogg, Martin, Cowie and Stevens. Anything close to three, sort of like a 3.10, a 3.15 is going to be a PB for these swimmers. And in lane three, Pauline Hogg. She is going to come home in a 3.09.16. That's a lovely time. Pauline entered with a 3.30 entry time. So that is 21 seconds off Pauline's entry. Well done to her. Peter Stevens, 3.18.99. He is just half a second over his entry. .320 for Catherine Martin, 5 seconds quicker than her entry time. And Alison Cowie, just outside of hers. Now, Jenny Ball, she's a 4:20.58 swimmer. Now, as the day goes along, we will see, of course, as with every swimming meet up and down the country, swimmers taking part in multiple events. And a 4:11.35 for Jenny. 9 seconds quicker than her entry time. Well done, Jenny.
The two referee.
Take your marks.
Full compliment in heat number two. Mary Johnson from Mid Sussex. Connor McCauley Conway, Kingston Royals. Patrick Allen for Woking. Teammates in 4 and 5, Anne Raymond and Nicholas Crew for Medway Maritime. Sarah Jones and Helen Andrews in 6 and 7 for Trojans. And in 8, Lewis Whitelock for Basildon Phoenix. Youngest in the pool, this one, Connor McCauley Conway, just 21 years of age, representing Kingston Royals. Yeah, big age advantage. Let's have a look at the entry times here. Mary Johnson, 3:16. In the middle, Anne Raymond and Nicholas Crew. What are their times? 3:05s and 3:03s. Trojan swimmers, just sub 3 minutes for them. And the youngster, Connor McCauley, a 3:13 for them. Out in front, the Trojan, Sarah Jones, 2:11. But it is very, very close. Lewis Whitelock for Basildon Phoenix. He's going to push her every single stroke of the way. And this is going to be a brilliant finish. Look at this. 6 swimmers coming in. Thrashing towards the line. 2:56.56 for Sarah Jones. Lewis Whitelock, a couple of seconds back in the end for Basildon Phoenix. Third place of that race towards the line. Patrick Allen for Woking. Anne Raymond. One of our two Medway Maritime swimmers. And Helen Andrews in fifth position. What a brilliant race that was. Let's go, Becky. Woo-hoo!
Swimmers, will you leave the pool by the side, please? Swimmers, will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you.
Heat 3, referee.
Take your marks.
Heat number 3, you are watching Jenny Vick for Erith District, Susie Hall for Tonbridge, Matt Conrad Jones at Medway Maritime, Philippa Williams at Wickham District, Spencer teammates in 5 and 6, Sudan Magent and Laura Kerrigan, Crawley's Becky Monaghan in Southern, and representing Dover Lifeguards Club, Tracy Anstis is in 8. So we've seen a few sub 3 minute times, and by the time we get to heat number 9, we get incredibly close to sub 2 minutes. Let's wait and see. Early leader in lane number 3, Matt Conrad Jones, 56-year-old from Medway Maritime. His entry time, 2:50. Same as the time for Philippa Williams. And this is going to be a super exciting final out and back now. You've got four swimmers in this. Laura Kerrigan takes the lead over Tracy Anstis and Becky Monaghan. Then your early leader, Conrad Jones. So it's been all change. And look at Laura Kerrigan go. Laura's entry time, 2:45. Very close to the time of Suzanne Maidment for Kerrigan. Representing Spencer will close things out, 2:37.67. She'll be over the moon with that time. 8 seconds quicker than her entry. Tracy Anstis likewise, a 2:40.51. Two seconds quicker than Tracy's entry as well. So Time's being beaten on a regular basis here.
Heat four, referee.
Take your marks.
Heat number four approaching halfway through our second event. In the pool, Esther Seffi for Spencer, Sam Bradley, Team Luton, Hannah Knightley, Kingston Royals, Jeff Baker of Rochford, Anthony Corbin in five of Trojans, Vicky Linton-Crook of Crawley in six, Haventon Waterlooville's Gemma Patterson in seven, and Crawley again in eight. This time with Sharon Burchill. Every single entry time now 2:40 or below. Between 2:30 and 2:40, in fact. So as we progress through these last five heats, they should really get closer and closer on paper. Doesn't always come to fruition. Super start though by Sharon Burchill, one of the home club swimmers, in eight. Her entry 2:37, she is the fastest in the pool on the entry time list. Leads over Hannah Knightley, representing Kingston Royals. So it's all about the clock now. Again, her entry 2:37, and she's going to be absolutely well under that. It's a 2:19.62. Yeah. 2:29.47 for Sharon Burchill. It was 2:33 for Hannah Knightley.
We have a time discrepancy, event number two, heat number two. The official time for lane eight is 2:59.03. That's the time discrepancy. The official time for lane eight is 2:59.03. Thank you. Heat five, referee.
Take your marks.
heat number five. Anne-Marie Adams for Medway Maritime in one. And then comes Matthew Winsmith for Woking, Sean Herdman-Grant for Basingstoke, Laura Cook for Bracknell, David Cargill representing Crawley, Suzanne Wilding, Erith and District, Doriani Peruzzi for Basingstoke, and Nigel McDonald again for Crawley. Plenty of home swimmers, as you'd imagine, in today's meet already. Two quick starters. Sean Herdman-Grant and Doriana Peruzzi not hanging about at all through their first 100 metres. Nigel McDonald for Crawley in lane number eight. Just trying to hang on to the coattails of Peruzzi. When it's nip and tuck, you can, of course, use the advantage. You're, of course, in the wash a little bit if you're right to the few metres, 5 metres back, as McDonald finds himself right now. But it's nice to tag along to somebody, let them pull you along a little bit psychologically. Peruzzi goes out one more time. Then Herdman, Grant, McDonald's exactly the same time, 1:47.57 for second place. As always, age groups, genders. But of course, you do want to win your heat. And it might even win you a medal as well. Or win you a medal. So back she comes. 2:17.68 for Doriana Peruzzi. Wonderful time. And second place, there was nothing to separate them 100 metres ago. There is now. Nigel McDonald, 2:28.12. 12 hundredths ahead of Sean Herdman-Grant. And just missing out on the top three spot, Suzanne Wilding. And it's nice to get those official results on the scoreboards now at the end of each race. Very, very helpful. 5 feet down, four to go.
Heat six, referee.
Take your marks.
Taking part in heat six from lane number one onwards, Paul Smoothly for Guildford City, Sorrel Kenny for Trojans, Laura Fenwick, City of Oxford, Jasmine Lambert, Royal Tunbridge Wells, Charles Wilson for Wickham District, Carl Simpson for Spencer, Russell Clash, Basingstoke, and Kira Neal for Basildon Phoenix. And look at this. Through 75 metres. We suggested they might get a little bit closer, but these are almost inseparable through 100. Entry times in all these heats now is going to be really, really close, not a lot to separate them at all. We're looking for anywhere between 2:20 and 2:30. Ish. It's a big ish, big caveat on the ish. Look at this. There are going to be no predictions at all in these last 50 metres. This is a wonderful race. There's 1.5 seconds separating your top 5-6 here. Well, who's going to push on? Russell Clash in 7 looking strong, as is Carl Simpson in 6. Back they come. Who's going to make a move? Heat number 6. Russell Clash moving on for Basingstoke, the 53-year-old. Superb finish. 2:21.67 over Charles Wilson and Carl Simpson. Plenty of wonderful noise in the gallery. Always lovely to hear that.
We have a time discrepancy for event 2, heat 4, lane 2. That's event 2, heat 4, lane 2. The official time is 2:43.92. That's 2:43.92. Thank you. Heat 7, referee.
Take your marks.
Wow, what a thriller in Heat 6. Our Heat 7 swimmers, Laura Hibbard of Hillingdon, Amy Barton, Wickham District, Philip Bradley, Medway Maritime, Kevin Wills, Wickham District, Dean Blackman for Woking, Ralph Pinnell, Borough of Newham, Sarah Hunt for Basingstoke, and James McTavish for the City of Southampton. Entry times now go sub-2:20. Again, only a few seconds separating all 8 swimmers on the entry times. And not the hugest difference in age groups here either. From the low 30s through the 40s. In fact, Ralph Pinnell, oldest in the pool at 61. But with an entry time equal to those, a couple of decades younger than him. So one more time, out and back. Your leader, James McTavish, Sarah Hunt, Dean Blackman, Ralph Pinnell, all happening on the near side. As if 2 separate races here, near 4, far 4. James McTavish looking incredibly strong though. A 2:16 was his entry time, but look at Dean Blackman. Last 25 metres, they're going to go into the wall together. And it will be Dean Blackman, 2:13.89 for Blackman. 5 seconds quicker than his entry time. James McTavish also beating his comfortably in lane 8. There's confirmation of those times in heat number 7. Blackman, McTavish, Hunt, top 3 in the heat.
Heat 8, referee.
Take your marks.
Penultimate heat in the 200 freestyle mixed event. From lane 1, Alex O'Kelly for Basingstoke. Stevie Butler, Rushmore Royals, Chris Smith for Teddington. Piotr Walczynski for King's Cormorant. Fiona Carroll, City of Southampton. Yigit Guven for London. William Wilding, Erithan District. And Sammy Wilson for Rushmore Royals. Entry times, we are now as down as low as 2:10. It's only in the final heat that we go sub that. And already on their final 50, in front, Chris Smith representing Teddington. However, in six, look at Yigit Guven. A wonderful last 50 metres for them. Into the wall. What's the time going to be? 2:10.78. Bang on the fastest entry times. William Wilding moved into second, and early leader Chris Smith settles for third in the heat. Wait till these get confirmed. There they are on the in-venue scoreboard for you. Heat 8 all done, one more to go.
Heat 9, referee.
Lane 4, can you move in to close to the edge? Thank you very much. Take your marks.
Final heat. From lane one, Dan Walker for Crawley, Hugh Jones for Bracknell, Danny Baker, Rochford, Mark Tuddenham for Woking, James Vick, Erithan District, Ronald Garcia for Reading, Carl Halford representing City of Southampton, and Lawrence Gilfrin. For Rushmore Royals. Now, Mark Tuddenham is the man to watch here. Entry time 1:55.86 in lane number four. To his side, James Vick, a 2:01.35. And to his left, Danny Baker. Oh. Danny's entry time, 2:03. And with halfway done, now he starts to make his move, body length advantage on the field. Take Mark out of the equation here, you got a pretty close race. Nobody yet gone too close to 2 minutes. We might get a full eight doing that here. 1:29 for Tuddenham. It's going to be mighty, mighty tight to go sub 2 minutes. Looking like it's going to be absolutely bang on that 2 minute mark. And Danny Baker going really nicely in three. Anticipated James Vick being the closest competitor. Keep your eye on Lawrence Gilfrin in lane number eight as well. All about the time here, going to miss out on the 2 minutes, but a solid win in 2:02.69. 2:04 Danny Baker, 2:05 Ronald Garcia. Mentioned Lawrence Gilfrin, 2:05.92 for him. Some superb times in our final heat of the mixed 200s.
Swimmers, will you leave the pool by the side, please? Thank you very much. Will you leave the pool by the side?
Event 3 is the open male 100 metre backstroke, heat 1 of 3, referee.
Take your marks.
We have gone from 400 to 200, now to 100. Just three competitors in heat number one. Sam Bradley for Team Luton in lane three. Louis Martin for Dover Life in four. And Nick Skinner for Basingstoke in lane number five. Entry times around about 1:20, that kind of window, maybe a few seconds either side. Nick Skinner, quick start for the 48-year-old for Basingstoke. And nobody is going to catch Nick Skinner. He'll be our first heat winner in the male 100 back, and he will set a time for the rest of heat of 1:14.68. Louis Martin 1:20, and Sam Bradley around 1:25. Bang on, 1:25.81.
Okay, swimmers, thank you very much. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you. Heat 2, referee. Take your marks.
Heat 2 from lane 1, Simon Berry, Nigel Vickers, Matthew Taylor, Andrew Squires, Patrick Gore, Adam Harper, Martin Schofield and Mike Hodgson. Estimated finishing time around about the 1:10, 1:15. Saying that, Martin Schofield and Mike Hodgson are making this a two-man race early doors. Not hanging around at all. They'll turn together to come home. And Mike Hodgson will turn the fastest. This is going to be a superb time for Mike. 106.07 for Woking's Mike Hodgson. That's a fantastic time. Likewise, sub 110 for Martin Schofield.
Okay, swimmers, thank you very much. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Thank you, swimmers. Leave the pool by the side.
Heat 3, referee.
Take your marks.
Third and final heat in this event. Chris Unsworth, Daniel Cotton, Alexander Edge, Adam Toy, Daniel Wass, Richard Hazard, Paul Allen, and Martinus Marks. We could get pretty close now to the 1 minute mark. Let's wait and see. In 3 and 4, Alexander Edge and Adam Toy. They will be very much potential medalists here. Final heat. And it is the white cap of Alexander Edge that will take it 101.17 for the man from Portsmouth North Sea. Just holding off Adam Toy for Solent.
Thank you, swimmers. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you.
Event 4 is the female 100 metre backstroke, heat 1 of 5, referee.
Take your marks.
And on to our women's 100 back. Susan Dewar of Haventon Waterlooville, Marianne Davey of Redhill, and Amanda Doyle of King's Cormorant are our first three competitors. And a sizable lead for Amanda Doyle. And she will turn for home. Amanda's entry time for this one was, just find it on the paperwork, 1:46. So not only is she gonna win this heat, looks like she's going to set a quicker time to entry by around 7 or 8 seconds. So, wonderful performance to kick off her day. a 1:40.38, 6 seconds quicker. In lane number four, Marianne Davy. Her entry, 1:59.33. So she's going to be close to this. No running clock. We'll wait for this clock to stop. 2:02 for Marianne Davy, just outside her entry. And Suzanne Dewar, a 2:10 was her entry time. Again, she's just going to miss out on that, it looks like. 2:14.83.
Well done, swimmers. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you very much.
Heat 2, referee.
Take your marks.
Six competitors in heat number two. Jenny Vick for Erith and District, and Gail for Mid Sussex. Sam Petter for Southern Oaks. Mary Johnson for Mid Sussex. Lindsay Edwards for Trojans, and Trojans always get a good cheer, don't they? Loving the Trojans. And Tracy Martin for Dover Lifeguard Club. It is Lindsay Edwards and Tracy Martin side by side, stroke for stroke. And a two-woman race here for the heat win. And they will turn in sync with 25 metres to swim. Let's have a look then. Last 5 metres cannot be separated. It will be on the fingertips touch on the wall. It's going to go the way of Tracy Martin, 1:29.44, 1:29.84, 0.4 seconds. And they both beat their entry times, both going sub-1:30 for the first time. Love to see that.
Thank you, swimmers. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you very much.
Heat 3, referee.
Take your marks.
A full complement of athletes in this heat. Susie Hall for Tonbridge, Sarah Davison with Sussex, Lanaid Walker for Whitney, Alain Sang, Borough of Newham, Emma Cartwright for Otters, Vicky Linton Crook for Crawley, Rona Courtier for Larkfield, and Becky Monaghan for Crawley. We're into the low to mid 120s on the entry times. And once again, lane 7 and 8 is Rona Courtier and Becky Monaghan. They will lead the field. What are their times going to be? Let's have a look. Running clock has stopped in venue, so you'll know as soon as we do. 122 and 123. We thought it would be low 120s. It absolutely is bang on. Elaine Tseng, 123.50 in the middle for third place.
Thank you, swimmers. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Thank you. Will you leave the pool by the side?
Heat 4, referee.
Take your marks.
Penultimate heat in our women's 100 metre backstroke. Gemma Patterson, Deborah Arezu, Zoe Hasty, Alex O'Kelly, Laura Fenwick, Laura Hibbard, Hannah Bowie, and Jessica Brown. And we are into the teens over 1 minute for our entries. But look at Deborah Arezu go in lane number 2, representing Windsor. She's having a wonderful swim, as is in Southern Hannah Bowie. Those two, in fact, Hannah Bowie's going to come through here in the pink cap, representing Medway Maritime. Or is Deborah Arezu going to hold on? Here comes Laura Hibbert as well. 112 for Hannah Bowie, 113 Deborah Arezu. Fantastic competition swimming in heat number 4. But Hannah Bowie takes it 112.15, chased all the way. In fact, I think Deborah led with 25 to go. One more heat to come.
Heat 5, referee.
Last chance then in the 100 back for the women. Laura Kearns, Lindsay Wright, Yolanda Spear, Lara Charlton, Kirsty Johnson, Joe Corbin, Emily Quick, and Bethany Collins. Fastest out the blocks, Yolanda Spear, representing Medway Maritime. followed closely by Lara Charlton and Kirsty Johnson. But at the tip of the spear is Yolanda Spear. Her time is going to be sub-110, fastest time of the event, 106.27. Or 107s for Charlton and Johnson. Joe Corbin also going sub-110. Just four women achieving that in the 100 back.
Event 5 is the men's 100 metre breaststroke, heat 1 of 3, referee.
Once again, for the men, just three heats, but a full pool in all three, so 24 competitors. Up first, Paul Catherall, John Darby, Stephen Green, Matthew Walcher, Nikolaos Jogas, Louis Martin, Tom Forsey, and Nigel McDonald. Expect around about 130, between that and 140, a fairly wide range of entry times here. If someone goes really quick, they could even go sub-130, and in fact that is looking nailed on, because in 6, 7 and 8, Martin, Forsey and McDonald are looking absolutely fantastic. Be well under that, my goodness me. What a finish to race number one. 6/100ths of a second, McDonald over Forsey. Louis Martin, 1:23.37. All three of those great times. And great entertainment for us too.
Heat 2, referee.
Heat 2, you're going to start seeing names already in their second and third events here. Giancarlo Amaral Pinto, Philip Bradley, James Russell, Keane Hodge, Bryn Hughes, Mark Deakin, Tom Hargreaves and Joshua Patel. Once again, very difficult to separate them. Lane number one. That is Giancarlo Amaral Pinto. Will it be his race? Yes, it will. 1:12.61. Just 0.13 of a second between him and Kian Hodge. In fact, tied with Tom Hargreaves in seven.
Heat three, referee.
Third and final heat, Chris Unsworth, William Bowler, Gregory de Tertre, Oliver Lungley, James Vick, Mark Tottenham, Roger King, and Yevgenius Poutans. Oliver Lungley over William Bowler and Gregory de Tertre, three men swimming together. Make that four with James Vick. They are racing for middle, these guys. Again, results available, just scan the QR code. Results will be posted on the back walls behind the gallery as well. Everything available to you. In lane four though, Oliver Lungley in his home pool for Crawley will set the fastest time of the event, 107.13. 109 for William Bowler, going sub 110. As does Gregory de Tertre, just 0.2 of a second back. Brilliant racing in our third and final heat.
Event six is the female 100 meter breaststroke. Event heat one of four, referee.
Four heats to come, setting us off, Susan Dewar for Haventon Waterlooville, Denise Humphreys for Godalming, and Claudine Day for Redhill and Reigate. Looking at around about 2 minutes, and even from there up to 2:20 would be a great time for Susan Dewar. And then we get as quick by just four heats, again by heat four, by the way, down into the very low 120s, even a couple of entry times in the 110s. So this will get super fast very, very quickly. Very little to separate Denise Humphreys and Claudine Day. And they're very similar ages too, so this could potentially, although with three heats to go, be a direct competition between these two ladies. And who will get home? It will be Claudine Day. 154.38 and 155. Great times for both these women. Susan Dewar is a 2.20 entry time. And she's potentially just going to miss out on that. But we've already seen her in the pool a couple of times. And she'll close out heat number one. And it's going to be a time of 2.27 for Dewar.
Heat two, referee.
Heat two, Alison Cowie in one for Buzzard and Phoenix. In two, Victoria Roughly for Dover Life. In three, Helen Andrews for Trojans. In four, Anne Raymond at Medway Maritime. Then Kim Tarrant for City of Southampton. Dover Lifeguards teammates Donna Wickens and Eleanor Matthews in six and seven. And in eight, Nicola Court for Havant and Waterlooville. Now we will go a bit quicker naturally in heat two. We're at about 130, 140. In lane number eight, Nicola Court for Havant and Waterlooville. .135.66 on the entry, and she's going to go almost bang on that. .136.48. Look at those times flurry in from the bottom. 37s for Donna Wickens and Eleanor Matthews. 38 for Kim Tarrant. 1-2-3-4 in lanes 8-7-6-5.
Heat three, referee.
Penultimate heat in the event. From lane one, Karen Gendon, Rachel Bartholomew, Fiona Wiggins, Linda Sprigg, Samantha Usher, Claire Tagg, Anne-Marie Adams, and Rebecca Pritchard. And now we move into the very low 130s, and maybe even into the sub 130s. Who has left their best for competition day. Looks like Karen Gendon, representing Bracknell in one, has done just that. And she looks to very nearly be neck and neck with Anne-Marie Adams in seven, representing Medway Maritime. And in fact, Can she hold her off in the white cap and the pink cap? Karen Jendon, fantastic start, and she holds on 129.23. Very, very nice time indeed. 6 seconds quicker than the entry time, in fact. And Anne-Marie Adams, a superb 130.
Let's go, Lindsay!
Heat four, referee.
Final heat sees Carly Moon, Rhiannon Elston, Lottie Prestonhouse, Jennifer Holland, Megan McDonough, Lindsay Wright, Janet Chan, and Amanda Heath. Quick start in four for Jennifer Holland, representing Wickham District in the distinctive green cap of Wickham. And she will lead by half a body length over Megan McDonough. She's representing Otter. To her right-hand side in three, Lottie Prestonhouse for Basingstoke. They'll be the first three to turn. In fact, Janet Chan, a fellow Otter, turns very closely too. But this is really all about the time of Jennifer Holland here. She's a 1:14 swimmer. She's not going to beat that. She's just outside, but it will be the fastest time of the event. 1:17.32. 1:22, Megan McDonough. And 1:24, Lottie Prestonhouse. Saving the best till the last heat.
Event seven is the men's 100 meter freestyle. Heat one of seven, referee.
And our events get quicker and quicker. Freestyle time. Heat one, Peter Stevens, Connor McCauley Conway, Patrick Allen, Nicholas Crew, Vittorio Velisco, Nicholas Sogas, and Keith Parkin. Vittorio Velisco, not hanging around at all. 33 seconds to halfway. That's phenomenal swimming. In seven, Keith Parkin. And in six, Nikolai Shokas. In their own right, going very nicely, but Vittorio Velisco, his swim is that really splitting this field up, to say the least. And it's going to be a wonderful time of 110.5. Superb from Varisco. Best of the rest, Keith Parkin holds off Shokas for a 119 and a 117.
Heat 2, referee.
Competing are Lewis Whitelock, Andrea Struna, Sean Finch, Neil Hammond, Larry Chan, Matt Conrad Jones, Luca Milana, and Jeff Baker. Eight swimmers, Southern clubs represented, as two for the Mid Sussex team. Finch and Chan, but it's Andrea Struna in two, and it is Larry Chan in five. They will turn. Unfortunately, a stop for Sean Finch. Back to the front in eight. Jeff Baker making a move as well. But right down the middle, Larry Chan is going to set a time, 109.44. First man to go sub 110. And it is the Mid-Sussex man.
Heat 3, referee.
Heat number three, Martin Ryan, Sean Herdman-Grant, Nigel Vickers, David Cargill, Simon Berry, Carl Simpson, Mike Jones, and Julio Olivier. And again, we're going to see some absolutely thrilling times here. Julio Olivier for Teddington in lane number eight. What's this going to be? 101.91. Wow. Equally great times for Carl Simpson, 104. 104 for Nigel Vickers. These are great, great times. Everybody sub 110, but 101 for Olivier. Hats off.
Heat 4, referee.
Heat 4, Paul Smoothly, Thomas Quinn, Mark Ross, Keith Goggin, Peter Riddle, Matthew Nash, Ralph Pinnell, and Andrew Squires. So are we going to see our first sub 60 seconds here? It was a quick old time from Olivier in 3. Might not see it just yet. But it won't be far away. Once again, lane number eight, heavily involved, Andrew Squires. And in five, Peter Riddle. Oh, 1 minute and 1 hundredth of a second for Andrew Squires. Oh, it's painfully close to sub 1 minute. Peter Riddle, 101.85 and 102.09, Ralph Pennell. Maybe next time.
Heat 5, referee.
You are watching Stevie Butler, Jake Doyle, Tom Whitehead-Clark, Richard Hazard, Chris Smith, Daniel Cotton, Kieran Hodsey-Kilroy, and Craig Simmons. Hodson, Kilroy, and Simmons in 7 and 8. And it's the former that leads, representing Woking. We're going to go sub 60 seconds by a distance here. 56-46 for Kieran Hodson-Kilroy. Craig Simmons, 56-84. And rounding out your top three, Daniel Cotton. Six men sub 60 seconds.
Heat 6, referee.
Penultimate heat of the 100 free for the men. Sean North, Dan Walker, Luke Fowle, Spencer Turner, Ollie Epinassi, William Wilding, Connor Brunt and Hugh Jones. And in 5, Ollie Epinassi representing Basingstoke up there with his teammate leads the way. Connor Court for Woking in 7. In fact, on that turn, has he moved into the pole position? I think he has. Back they come then. Three men go towards the wall, but Connor Brunt, representing Woking. What's his time? 55.01 for Connor Brunt. Early leader, Ollie Espinassi, 56.12. And Spencer Turner, 56.44.
Heat 7, referee.
Last chance in the men's 100 meter freestyle. Martinus Marks, Fraser Pay, Jamie Cunningham, Alexander Smith, James Vick, Lawrence Gilfrin, Danny Baker and Noah Walton. Alexander Smith, entry time 52.24. James Vick, 52.57. One clear leader though, Smith. And to his side is Jamie Cunningham in 3. 54.44, he's 2 seconds slower on the entry. Cunningham over Smith, not going to be the case in the pool here though. 52.44, Alexander Smith. 2/10 shy of his entry time, but a solid win in the 100 freestyle.
Event 8 is the female 100 meter freestyle, heat 1 of 6, referee.
And off we go with the women's 100 free. Three competitors, heat 1. Jenny Ball for Ride in 3. Mariana Davey, Redhill and Reigate in 4. And Havant and Waterlooville, Pauline Hogg, is in lane number 5. Pauline Hogg, a 1:33 swimmer. Marianne Davey, a 1:48 entry. And Jenny Ball, a 2:05. So not a surprise at all to see a split, even at the early stage. All three women in different age categories. And setting the first time of our 6 heats. Pauline Hogg, a 1:26.46. 7 seconds quicker than her entry time. Well done, Pauline. In lane 4, Mariam Davey will be second home. 1:48 her entry time. Will be just outside that. And Jenny Ball, can she go faster than 2:05? Looking good, isn't it? 2:01 for Jenny Ball, 4 seconds off her PB entry.
Heat 2, referee.
You are watching Claudine Day, Amanda Doyle, Jenny Vick, Alex Smith, Hannah Knightley, Annie Belasco, Laura Kerrigan and Becky Monahan. And at the tip of the pack, Hannah Knightley, and they fall away to her left and to her right. A 1:19 is the entry time from Knightley, and she's looking pretty nailed on to take a good chunk of seconds off that right now. Behind her, Annie Belasco, Laura Kerrigan to her right. A 1:09 from Hannah Knightley. That is 10 seconds, double digits quicker than her entry time over 100 meters That's a massive, massive difference. Anna Belasco, it was Becky Monaghan that came through to take third place over Laura Kerrigan. All happening on the near side.
Heat three, referee.
In the pool, Tracy Anstis, Suzanne Maidment, Emma Cartwright, Catherine Ashford, Heidi Gore, Elizabeth Stemp, Gemma Pattison, and Rona Courtier. And the pack will get a little bit tighter now. There'll be very rarely much of a difference as long as everybody's on some sort of form in the differences between first and last. Now that 109 was pretty phenomenal, and we might not see that again for a couple of heats. Although Rona Courtier will go very close. It's going to be a 111-ish, or we're going to see 111.41. Gemma Pattison, Elizabeth Stemp, your top three. 111, 112, 113.
Heat four, referee.
Competing, Laura Cook, Petra Paulinova, Sally Ritchie, Kim Holmes, Emily Quick, Bethany Collins, Elizabeth Tarr, and Rhiannon Elston. Southern clubs represented, with two from Teddington, Tarr and Paulinova. It is Bethany Collins that turns for home first. To her right-hand side, Elizabeth Tarr. And not too much competition to the left-hand side. Again, all these women, different age groups. We just look at heat times and winners when we're commentating here. And Bethany Collins, a 104.88. That is fantastic. 107 Elizabeth Tarr and 108 Sally Ritchie.
Heat five, referee.
An ultimate heat, Jasmine Lambert, Laura Chapman, Laura Fenwick, Liz Price, Doriane Perozzi, Kira Neal, Amy Barton, and Lauren Palmer-Jones. Fast start through 25 and 50 for Lauren Palmer-Jones. Has she gone out a little bit too quickly, possibly? Going steady in four, Liz Price. And coming back now in five, Doriane Perozzi. Still Palmer-Jones that leads into the final 25. Perozzi and Price, they're not going to catch her, are they? She'll lead from start to finish. The City of Canterbury's Palmer-Jones, 102.59. Perozzi not far back in the end, 103.22. And then Amy Barton.
Heat six, referee.
Final heat. Laura Hibbard, Hope Pace, Sarah Hunt, Melissa Dolby, Sammy Wilson, Kellen Caldwell, Michelle Ware, and Ellie McDonald. Can anybody go sub 60 seconds? We've been close. Two of these swimmers do have entry time sub 60. That is Sammy Wilson and Melissa Dolby. The two in the centre, but Kellen Caldwell looking strong in six. Here comes Melissa Dolby. She can, 59.5. One woman sub 60 in the 100 free. And it is Southampton's Dolby. Caldwell and Ware just outside. But sub 101.
Event nine is the male 50 meter backstroke. Heat one of four, referee.
Right then, these are going to be super quick. Our next dozen or so heats, all going to be 50 metres. Up first, Sean Finch, Anthony Corbin, Sam Bradley, Phil Atwood, Louis Martin, Matthew Susmus, and Joe Kirkpatrick. Winning time, heat one. Going to be Joe Kirkpatrick, 35.11. Nice way to start us off. Well,
Heat two, referee.
Up next, Terence Holness Wright, Dylan Conway, Matt Taylor, Derek Hutton, Patrick Gore, Benjamin Smith, and Adam Harper. And just like that, in the time to read out the names, Dylan Conway is home 28-28. Superb by Conway, representing Kingston Royals.
Heat three, referee.
Heat three already. John Etherington, Piotr Walczynski, Mark Deakin, Jonathan Bentham, Jake Doyle, Chris Unsworth, Paul Allen, and Robert Gilbert. Can we see another sub 30? You might not see it just yet. It was out of the ordinary in heat number two. It's going to be very, very close, though. Just outside for Paul Allen and Robert Gilbert. And split by just 100th of a second, those two men at the top. 30.85 over 30.86.
Heat four, referee.
John Fitzgerald, Martinus Marks, Alexander Edge, Adam Toy, Daniel Wass, Ollie Espinassi, Richard Hazard, and Martin Schofield in heat number four. And this one looks to be going down the middle. Four men in it, Edge, Toy, Wass, Espinassi. Can they be separated just by 600s? Adam Toy gets it. And in fact, is that just 3 100 separating the top four? Wow. Two tenths separating the top four.
Event 10 is the female 50 metre backstroke. Heat 1 of 6, referee.
Turn of the women once again, and their 50 back, 6 seats for them, in contrast to the men's 4. Susan Dewar, Marilyn Linnington, Marianne Davey, Catherine Martin and Christine Goodair are your 5 competitors. And it's the latter, Christine Goodair, representing King's Cormorant, who will be your first woman to set a time, 46.98. Time to beat for the rest in Christine's age category, likewise for Catherine Martin. Pretty nip and tuck after that. Back to Susan Dewar.
Heat 2, referee.
A full pool made up of Victoria Ruffley, Sam Petter, Anne Gale, Mary Johnson, Alison Gwynn, Denise Humphreys, Tracy Martin, and Lindsay Edwards. There are 3 Mid-Sussex Marlins in 3, 4, and 5 occupying the centre of the pool. However, Tracy Martin for Dover Lifeguards Club in Southern. It'll be her heat, a time of 41.18, new fastest time for the event through 2 heats. Lindsay Edwards, and over in lane number 1, Victoria Ruffley in the top 3.
By the side, please. Thank you. Will you leave the pool by the side?
Heat 3, referee.
Take your marks.
Elaine Zhang, Heidi Gore, Megan Thompson, Sarah Davison, Alex Smith, Lindsay Kellione, Emma Cartwright, and Catherine Ashford. A much closer affair. Now, who can we pick out here? Maybe Emma Cartwright in Southern. moves towards the line. Keep your eye on Elaine Zhang in 1:36.86 for Cartwright. And it was, in fact, Catherine Ashford. Both exactly the same age, these two women. Cartwright and Ashford, they're your top two. Megan Thompson got third place.
Well done, swimmers. Will you leave the pool by the side, please? Will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you.
Heat 4, referee.
Take your marks.
Watching Becky Monahan, Rona Courtier, Gail Henry, Gemma Patterson, Kim Holmes, Sally Ritchie, Laura Fenwick and Valerie Melville. Once again, very difficult to pick out a winner with 10 metres to go. Laura Fenwick, is she just ahead of Gail Henry and Gemma Patterson? Let's find out. She was 36.57. By around half a second.
Okay, swimmers, thank you very much indeed.
In fact,
will you leave the pool by the side?
Sally Ritchie
well
that squeezed
will
into second
the pool
place, 37.11.
Yes, will you get out? Thank you.
Heat 5, referee.
Take your marks.
Penultimate heat, you got Zoe Hasty, Jess Brown, Deborah Arezu, Lindsay Wright, Joe Corbin, Amy Barton, Bethany Collins, and Hannah Bowie. Lane number 8, Hannah Bowie going very nicely in the pink cap. In the middle, Lindsay Wright, also in pink. And there, your first two home. There's Joe Corbin, my mistake, 32.96. For Joe Corbin.
Well done, swimmers.
Then
will you leave
Bowie,
the pool by the side, please? Will you leave
and
the pool by the
Wright
side? Thank you very much.
Top three.
Heat 6, referee.
Take your marks.
Final heat in the backstroke. Fionn Thomas, Hope Pace, Yolanda Spear, Kirsty Johnson, Lara Charlton, Emily Quick, Lauren Palmer-Jones and Megan McDonough. Look at this, flying home. Oh, close to sub 30, Yolanda Spear, 30.92, fastest time of the event. Kirsty Johnson not far behind. and neither Lara Charlton.
Event 11 is the male 50 metre breaststroke, heat 1 of 6, referee.
Take your marks.
And we are in the closing straights for our morning session. Or morning slash afternoon session. 50 metre breaststroke for the men, the women, and then just a couple of mixed 200 butterflies to finish off. First out, Peter Stevens, Sam Bradley and David Proctor. And it's Proctor that leads the way. I think Proctor's swimming without any goggles on. Unique, but it doesn't faze him. Takes the win 45-65. Wonder if he just forgot those.
Heat 2, referee.
Take your marks.
Keith Parkin, Timothy Waters, Larry Chan, Neil Hammond, Andreas Struner, and Phil Atwood. So 45 seconds the time to beat. We'll go pretty quick, in fact, on these. We'll just looking through the timings here. Wouldn't be surprised if we get right down to the mid-30s and that region. What can we hit in heat number two? 41s for Neil Hammond and Andreas Struner. Struner going 2/100ths of a second quicker, though.
Heat 3, referee.
Swimmers, will you stand down, please? Will you stay off the blocks, wait for the referee? Take your marks.
Stephen Green, Matthew Walcher, Terence Holness-Wright, Tom Forsey, Mark Wortham, Nicolas Sogas, Yichi Guven, and Nigel McDonald. Right then, this time 35.87 for Yichi Guven, representing OTS London.
Heat 4, referee.
Take your marks.
Heat 4 of 6, Patrick Gore, Louis Martin, Derek Hutton, Spencer Turner, Mike Jones, Philip Bradley, James Russell, and Bryn Hughes. Bryn Hughes against three men down the centre in 4, 5 and 6. Takes it, 33.81, new fastest time through four heats. Philip Bradley, second position. Spencer Turner in third.
Heat 5, referee.
Take your marks.
Mark Deakin, Tom Hargreaves, Yes Gengis, Poutans, Mark Tottenham, Chris Unsworth, Kian Hodge, Joshua Patel, and Martinus Marks. And it is in lane 4, Mark Tottenham. Seen him already today, performing very nicely indeed. 32.07 for Tottenham. Tom Hargreaves and tied third, Kian Hodge and Mark Deakin.
Heat 6, referee.
Take your marks.
Last chance, Connor Brunt, Mike Hodgson, William Bowler, Oliver Lungley, Robert Messenger, Gregory de Tertre, James Vick and Luke Fowle. And just like that, they are home. 30.53, Robert Messenger. 27 hundredths clear of Oliver Lungley.
Okay, swimmers, well done.
William
Will you leave
Bowler.
The ball on the side, please?
Superb
leave the ball on the side,
from start
thank
to
you.
Finish. Two more events to come this morning.
Event 12 is the female 50 metre breaststroke. Heat 1 of 5, referee.
Take your marks.
Right then, penultimate event of the session. Catherine Martin, Susan Dewar, Marianne Davey, Alison Gwynn, Denise Humphreys, and Alison Cowie. It's a yellow cap of Godalming, belonging to Denise Humphreys, that leads the way in heat 1. How close can she go to 50 seconds? Very close indeed. She can go 11 hundredths just outside. Takes the win. Alison Cowie 53.59. And Alison Gwynn also going sub 60 seconds. Very nice indeed.
Heat two, referee.
Take your marks. Stand down, please, swimmers. Stand down, sorry. Yeah, sorry about swimmers, that was my problem, not yours. Take your marks.
Off they go, Victoria Roughly. Christine Goodair, Suzanne Maidment, Robin Lee Upton, Megan Thompson, Linda Sprigg, Nicola Court, and Fiona Wiggins. Looking to go well under sub 50 seconds now, maybe into the very low 40s. And looking to do just that, representing Crawley, Linda Sprigg, 42.39. Solid time for Sprigg. Just over a second clear of Nicola Court and Megan Thompson.
Heat three, referee.
Take your marks.
You are watching Rachel Bartholomew, Claire Tagg, Karen Jenden, Eleanor Matthews, Tracy Anstis, Rebecca Pritchard, Samantha Usher, and Elizabeth Stemp. White cap, lane three, pink swimsuit. Karen Jenden representing Bracknell. Wonderful 40.31 for her, wins it by a couple of seconds. You won't see that too often in 50 metres. But Karen's done it. Two more heats to go.
Heat four, referee.
Take your marks.
Carly Moon, Hannah Bowie, Anne-Marie Adams, Philippa Williams, Lottie Preston-House, Lindsay Wright, Rhiannon Elston and Alex O'Kelly in your penultimate 50-metre heat in this session. In six, Lindsay Wright. It's going to be a second consecutive Crawley win if she gets home first. She does. And the first four home, all sub 40. 38.12 for your leader.
Heat 5, referee.
Take your marks.
And finally, Janet Chan, Hope Pace, Ellie McDonald, Jennifer Holland, Sammy Wilson, Fiona Carroll, Liz Price, and Fionn Thomas. So we've had four times sub 40 seconds. How many more can we get right now? Let's have a look down the middle. Holland and Wilson in varying degrees of shades of green, but they're going towards gold, of course. 35.98 for Jennifer Holland. Best time of the event, and she will be one of our
well
many
done, swimmers.
Gold medalists today.
Will you leave the pool by the side?
I
well done, will you leave the pool by the side? Thank you.
Event number 12, heat number 1, lane number 4. So that's event 12, heat 1, lane 4 for a technical infraction. Thank you. Event 13 is the mixed 200 meter butterfly. Heat 1 of 2, referee.
Take your marks.
And there are just two heats left in the session. This is our last event. No surprise. Only two heats in the mixed 200 meter butterfly. Very brave, well done. In the pool, Julian Meldrum, Donna Wickens, Esther Isepi, and Amanda Heath. It is girl power in heat number one. Our three ladies that lead, Donna, Esther, and Amanda. Teammates Isepi and Heath representing Spencer in 5 and 6. Could be a Spencer 1-2 in heat number one as the way things stand. And in the gold cap, in lane 6, Amanda Heath, representing Spencer, will lead into the final stages. It's a lead over a teammate, Esther Isepi. Then Donna Wickens, and a bit of work to do for Julian Meldrum. But of course, this is all about when there's only two heats, you're just setting a time here. As long as you finish, there's a very, very good chance of getting yourself a medal. But you do have to finish. And continues to lead Amanda Heath. And she's extended her advantage. And back out she goes. She will continue to be followed closest, still by her teammate, Isefi. It's a 6 seconds advantage. And equating to about 6 meters as well. Donna Wickens, another 5 or so seconds down. She could still catch Esther Isefi in second place. They are in different age groups, these girls. And Julian Meldrum, he will turn and go out and back one more time. But this one has all been about Amanda Heath. Continues to extend that lead, and she'll set a time for Heat 2 to beat of 3:11.73. Very nice 200 meter butterfly swimming. Her teammate, 3:23, doubled the advantage over the last 50 meters. Strong finish from Amanda Heath. Donna Wickens will wait for her time to be confirmed. Oh, 3:34 there. I think it was a bit less than that. I think that might be recalculated. Let's wait and see. Didn't look like 11 seconds back. And Julian Meldrum, one of only 5 men in the competition. And of course, age group ranked. Will 4:01 be enough to get Julian Meldrum a medal? One more heat to come.
Heat 2, referee.
Take your marks.
Final heat of the session. Alan Parkins for Crawley. Laura Kearns for Teddington. Giancarlo Amaral Pinto for Crawley. Dylan Conway for Kingston Royals. Henry Goodlad for Woking. Matthew Nash for City of Southampton. Bethany Collins for Hailsham. And Dave Feathers for Kingston Royals. And we're barely through 100 metres. And there is a significant split in the pool with Dylan Conway and Henry Goodlad leading by example, and well, barely leading one another. They are together, half a second separating them. That's nothing with 100 on butterfly to come. Behind them, Amaral Pinto and Nash, then Kearns and Collins. One more time into the fray for Conway and Goodlad. Out they go. Advantage Dylan Conway by just over 2 seconds. Leading the rest of the field, Giancarlo Amaral Pinto. He's had a fantastic third 50 metres. If he had a bit more time, he might even catch Henry Goodlad. But neither of them is likely to catch Dylan Conway now. And he will be a gold medalist in the 200 metre butterfly in a superb time of 2:17.69. And it was very close in the end. Henry Goodler just holding off the charging Amaral Pinto. There your top three. And some very happy supporters as well. And finishing off in fourth place was Matthew Nash in lane six. And Laura Kearns in lane two for Teddington. Finishing off our heat, Bethany Collins and Dave Pethers. That is heat
very
event.
Well done, swimmers.
And session all wrapped up.
Thank you very much, swimmers, and well done for all those who have taken part. Now, information, please, can you register for session two by 1 o'clock? From what I can tell, registration will end at 1 o'clock. Make sure you register yourselves. Don't be late on that. Warm up will begin at 1 o'clock for the swimmers, the female swimmers, 1 o'clock to 1:15, and the open swimmers from 1:15 to 1:30. Session two is scheduled to start at 1:45, so we need pool clear at 1:30.